is this? Who is this? Oh, little gremlin. She's a little gremlin. This is Dixie. I am puppy sitting, and I'm quite happy about that. Quite happy about that. Because she's small.
Hi, everybody, and welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel today. I'm going to be trying out some new makeup that I recently showed you in one of my beauty hauls. And I showed you a few products that I have never tried before, and I kind of asked if you guys wanted me to try it on camera so we could see together how do they perform, was it a good purchase, was it a mistake. So I've got some of them here, and then I've also put some other products that I will need to complete my makeup in there. But otherwise, this is actually the bag that the Bobbi Brown kit came in. So if you haven't seen that video, I will leave the link to it below. And I'm really excited to try some of these things because I've wanted to try them for a while now. Like, we will definitely be starting with the Bobbi Brown Vitamin Enriched Face Base. So this is like an all-in-one primer. And I know so many people rave about this. So I'm excited to try this. Obviously, all the packaging from Bobbi Brown, as usual, looks beautiful. And I have to say that this is a big jar. Like, you do get a lot of product in here, which is quite surprising. It is expensive, but it is 50 mil. So this is how it comes. So I think we will just dive straight in and get started. I've put my hair up just so it's out of my face. And this is how it looks there. And it's like a cream. So I've just wiped the lid on my hand, not to waste any product. And I think I'm gonna go straight in. I will try to use my fingers because that's how I would normally apply. Oh my God, this smells heavenly, absolutely heavenly. So today I'm actually not using a foundation. We will be using the RMS Uncover Concealer, which a lot of the times I just use a concealer as my foundation that I blend out. I'm just gonna apply this. I kind of applied it into my T-zone. And it feels nice. It feels like it's definitely filling in the pores. I'm gonna scooch you guys a little bit closer as well so you can see, but it definitely feels more like a skincare product than a normal primer that is maybe dimethicone based and like very thick. This feels really, really moisturizing. Like, my skin actually feels nourished, which feels rather lovely. Kind of pat it and press it in, because that's what I like to do with the primer. I kind of press it in to the pores. I've got a few little like red, it's not even breakouts, it's more of an irritation. I get that sometimes depending on what I eat. Sometimes if I have too much citrus, I get that, or strawberries. That is our step one. Our step two is going to be the concealer. So this is the one that I got, RMS Beauty, and it's called Uncover Up, and I got it in shade 22.5. It was on sale. The reason why I got these things, like I said in the video, is because they were on sale. So as always, I am using my dual-ended Huda Beauty brushes. I love these brushes. I don't really use any other ones at the moment, but I think first I'm gonna go in with my finger and just see how this applies. This is super creamy. My hope for this is that it is not as greasy as the glossier one, because I loved the glossier one for that purpose of like sheering out all over your face, but it just was a little bit greasy. By the way, I didn't get a lot of sleep last night. I haven't been sleeping very well. I'm dreaming a lot again. So I know a lot of different remedies and a lot of different ways to like improve your sleep, but I don't know, recently it just hasn't been working for me a lot. A lot of the times, like guided meditations, like listening to a guided meditation definitely helps. And I do that a lot. Like, I just put something on YouTube and like a guided meditation, and then I just listen to that and it sends me to sleep. Sometimes I use CBD oil, but like herbal teas and stuff like that is kind of a given. I do that anyways. Recently, I just dream a lot, and I get such a vivid, stressful dreams. Like, I wake up tired, and I definitely can see today that I'm a little bit tired. So I've just applied a little bit under my eyes, and I have to say it looks very, very natural, like super, super natural. And I think if you are after a very natural look, the color, by the way, is matching me really well. I was a little bit scared it might be a bit dark, but I think with the skin tone that I have at the moment, with a bit of warmth from the sun, it's doing a good job blending in. Okay, it's definitely covered them a little bit. Obviously, it's not like erasing them, but I would not expect that from something like this. It's definitely not looking as greasy as the glossier one did, because I used to use so much powder with the glossier one. This amount of coverage suits me personally just fine for an everyday, like if I'm not going out, if it's not like an event. It is super, super creamy. It applies so beautifully. I think you could do a great job with it using a brush or using your fingers. I just find using my fingers gives a very natural airbrush look in a way that it kind of melts it into the skin because your fingers are warm, so it's warming up the product. I'm gonna throw on some blush, and I'm just gonna use my Glossier Cloud Paint in Beam. This is like a nice peachy apricot color. And for something like this, like a very natural everyday makeup, I love using cream products instead of powders. It gives you that healthy look skin with not a lot of effort, because you don't even have to use brushes. And also it's for lazy people like me. So I love the Beam because it almost acts as a blush and a bronzer, because it gives you that kind of sun-kissed look, and I really like that. On the eyes, I'm actually going to use something super simple as well. It's the Easy On The Eyes color from H&M, and this is in color Frou-Frou, which is super cute. So this is how it looks. It's very creamy, like a bronzy, like a rose gold color. So what I do, I literally put it straight onto the eyelid, and then I use my finger to blend it out. So it just gives a little bit of color, a little bit of definition to the eyelid. They do these in so many different colors. Check them out. So affordable. By the way, I'm wearing their nail polish, which is kind of chipped a little bit because I've done it quite a few days ago. I think it's called October Russet, and I really, really love that. But this is a nice, shimmery, easy shadow. You can also go a bit under the eye. It looks quite pretty, like I quite like that kind of champagne shade. Let's do a little bit of brow, because I always feel like when you do your brows, it makes it look like you've done a bit more effort, but I'm not even going to pencil my brows today. I will just brush them through with the Benefit. What is this called? The letters always rub off the products. And I think this is called Gimme Brow. I think that's what it's called. So it's got little fibers in it, so I just brush it through my brows, and it just gives a little bit more definition. Brows are okay, but they're not very full, neither are they very dark, so it makes a difference when I actually do something about them. My mama has very thin brows, and I remember always thinking, oh my god, I'm gonna have very thin brows just like my mom. At the moment, my brows are a bit fuller than hers, but in the 90s, she definitely gave them a good pluck. Like, there wasn't much left of them once she went at them in the 90s. So I feel like I did that to myself as well. Again, like in early 2000s, I was definitely plucking my brows, especially here at the ends. I was plucking them so much. It was just a thing. Like, everybody was doing it. And I guess that's the thing, that the fashion and beauty changes so much and you follow it. And some of the things you can't quite get back. Like, my brows are okay, but they definitely felt the 90s on them. So I'm just looking if I need any powder. I've got some Laura Mercier powder here that I usually use. But you know what? I am not gonna use any powder. I'm quite happy with how my skin is looking. So I'm going to apply some mascara, and I'm going to use that new Bobbi Brown Smoky Eye Mascara. So this is in black, and as I remember, it's got a very big brush. So hopefully I'm not gonna poke my eye out with this mascara. I have to say that I am such a fan of the Kevin Aucoin mascara. I literally don't use any other And any other time that I end up using something else, I'm like, oh no, just go back to the Kevinuk one. It is doing a good job separating the lashes and really lengthening them. It's not clumping at all. But my problem with other mascaras than the Kevinuk one is that they smudge. And Kevinuk one doesn't smudge because it comes off in strings. So this is anyways the top lashes with the mascara, and it looks pretty good. My bottom lashes are very long, so I usually have to be very careful how much a mascara I put on, because otherwise it does go everywhere because of how long they are. Yeah, I like it. It's pretty good actually, and I like that it's small. So obviously this is like a tester size, like a travel size. And oh, hello, what's happening? What are you barking at? She's just constantly barking at something. She's constantly attacking something, fighting against the world. I might also put a little bit of these Radiant Touch Creamy Stick Highlighter from Kiko. I really, really love it. It's like a shimmery pink color. And I usually just put a little bit of it on the brush and then apply it onto the cheekbones and a little bit onto the cheek. But it just gives a very nice sheen. I will try to find the color. I don't think it's on the packaging, but I will put it in the description box below. I will link it anyways. But yeah, it just gives a little bit of a sheen. So from there, we just got lips left, and I've got that new lipstick from Tom Ford that is just looking fabulous. This is the lip color Sheer, and I've got in color 11 Mystique. Obviously, gorgeous packaging, stunning lipstick, very pink, has got the initials on it. Beautiful, like always such a shame to ruin it. I'm gonna go straight from the bullet and I'm gonna try and like build it up a little bit. So I'm gonna pat it on first. I like that they always have a very sharp edge if you wanna go on the contours of your lips. So I've just patted it in, and that is such a cute, fresh color. Like, I really love, in fact, I have this little palette from NARS that I've been using as a mirror, and it's got two of their like best sellers in it. So it's the Orgasm Blush and the Laguna Bronzing Powder. So I might apply just a little bit of the blush just on the apples of my cheeks, because I feel like it will look really nice with this lipstick. Maybe I will bronze up a touch with the same bronzer. This is such a good little palette, like it's got both, and sometimes I use the bronzer and as an eyeshadow as well. You can definitely use the blush as an eyeshadow too, and it's just a very like a universally nice shades. I think I also have a little lip balm somewhere. So this is another product that came in the kit, and it's the Extra Lip Tint from Bobbi Brown, and it's just a sheer lip gloss basically. So I'm just gonna pat it on top to make it a little bit glossier. Definitely used as a bit of a highlighter. I use my 8-hour cream the same way. But that is definitely it. Like, I'm really happy with how this is looking. It's looking quite nice and summery and fresh, and I like it. I'm very happy with the base and with the concealer. I think that they suit what I want from makeup really well. I really felt like my skin was very moisturized, and that's why when I was applying the concealer it went on so smoothly and kind of melted into the skin really well. Surprisingly, I do really like the mascara, which normally I'm like such a snob when it comes to mascaras, but I do like this one. Love the color on the lips. It's feeling so comfortable, especially the combination of the Tom Ford and the Bobbi Brown, because that lip balm is quite nourishing. But I really love the shade of it as well. So that is it, you guys. I like it. I don't know what my hair is doing today. My fringe has a mind of its own most of the time. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for hanging out with me. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't done that yet. And if you guys have any questions about the makeup that I showed or any other questions at all, pop them in the comment section below. Have a wonderful day, whatever you're doing, and I will see you guys very, very soon in my next video. Bye!